All right, let's take another one for today. This one says sine, show that sine A plus B all over 2 in bracket is equal to cos C all over 2. Show in any triangle ABC that sine A plus B all over 2 in bracket is equal to cos C all over 2. Yes, please, let's see what we can do. It's very simple. Now we have sine A plus B all over 2 is equal to cos C all over 2, and then we are dealing with triangle ABC. All right, now let's go. We discovered that the sum of a triangle is 180. Now we're gonna have A plus B plus C is equal to 180 degree. All right, but in above question, we are having A plus B. All right, so that means we're going to take A plus B in one side and then the rest in the other side. In our A plus B, all of A plus B plus C is equal to 180. So we're going to take two of them. Now we're going to take A plus B and then we take C to the other side. Then we're going to have A plus B is equal to 180 minus C. Now from here, let's divide by 2. Let's divide 2, everything by 2. So we're going to have A plus B divided by 2 is equal to 180 divided by 2 minus C divided by 2. All right? Or in another way around, you can say A plus B all over 2 equal to 180 all over 2 minus C all over 2. All right, now let's go. We're gonna have A plus B all over 2 equal to 180 divided by 2 will give us 90. So we're gonna have 90 minus C all over 2. All right, now let's take the sine of both sides. So we're gonna see that in our both question, we're having sine there, right? Now let's take the sine of it. Now we'll have sine A plus B all over 2 is equal to sine 90 minus C all over 2. Now pay attention here. Please, please, please pay attention. All right, I will also refer you to our previous tutorial that says trigonometric identities. We treated so many formulas. Very, very important in solving trigonometric questions, all right? So in one of those formulas, we discover that we have a formula under trigonometric ratios. Now under trigonometric ratios, we had a formula, and then that formula say sine 90 minus A is equal to cos A. Sine 90 minus A is equal to cos A. All right, now let's go see what we're gonna have here. We're gonna see that we've solved in our both question. So we get to a level that we say sine 90 minus C all over 2 is equal to sine A B all over 2. All right, now we're gonna see that in this expression, sine 90 minus C all over 2 is the same as sine 90 minus A. Is that true? So we have sine 90, and then we have C all over 2 to be A. So instead of us to write sine 90 minus C all over 2, we are going to replace it with what? Cos A. All right? We're going to replace it with what? Cos A. A, and then our cos A is what? C all over 2. You discover what I'm saying? Now we said, listen again, let me explain it again. In our solvings, we got to a level that we discovered that sine A plus B all over 2 is equal to sine 90 minus C all over 2, and then we say that in one of our formulas that sine 90 minus a is equal to cos a. All right, now and we discover that what we just solved, now we have 90 minus a all over 2 is similar to this our formula that we brought now. Now let's take sine 90, we have sine 90, and then we have minus, then c all over 2 is the same as a. All right, now it's equal to cos a. Now let's see, instead of us to write sine 90 minus c all over 2, replace it with cos c all over 2. You get it? You understand what we say here? Thank you very much. I know you have a question. Send your question to my email. I'll provide a session for that. All right, so now we will have sine a plus b all over 2 is equal to, instead of us to write sine 90 minus c all over 2, we replace it with what? Cos c all over 2, because cos c all over 2 is the same as sine 90 minus c all over 2. All right, yes, so finally we have arrived at what we are asked to prove, hence the proof. Thank you very much. Please keep practicing. I know it may not be easy, but please and please keep watching over and over, listening to it over and over until you get what I am saying. All right, thank you very much. Please don't forget subscribe for more videos. Thank you.